Hi stalkers, what's up? Welcome back to another vlog on my channel. It's the 20th of March 2018. It's currently 6:30 PM. I know it's a bit late to start a vlog at this time, but that's when all the fun starts. I'm gonna head to dinner now, and afterwards I'm going to Kelsea Ballerini concert. Yeah, she's one of my favorite new country artists at the moment because she's very talented, very beautiful, and her songs are really empowering, so I really like her. Oh, it's gonna be so fun.
Guys, it's your birthday while we're over in NZ. Yeah.
Tell you something, they're not all good songs, okay? Even though my dad and mom think that every song they ever wrote was a good song, they're not all good songs. And I'm down in the basement one day because that's where they kept me, and I don't know why. And my dad comes downstairs, he never comes all the way down there, and he's like so excited, he looks like a puppy that just got out of the cage. And I'm like, what's going on, Dad? What's going on? He's like, I want you to come upstairs and listen to this song. I think I just wrote a hit, or a smash, as we call it. And I was like, all right, I've heard this one before, Little Boy Blue. Let's go upstairs and check out this song. So I go up there and he starts playing me this song on the piano. I'm 15 years old, and I'm thinking to myself, man, this song sounds so much better than the other songs. This song is different. This song sounds like it could even be a hit. So what I thought is, now that I'm out here on the road, I might put yourself in my shoes that day and play you that song he played for me and let y'all decide. How does that sound to you guys? Culture quiz right now. Let's go! Fresh in it.
Melbourne? All the way from Melbourne? Who traveled to be here? This is amazing. I don't even know what to say. You know, last time I was here doing music, I was just putting out my record and I was introducing myself, and we were kind of nervous to do a show because I didn't know if anyone would show up. But you sold it out in like a week! So, by default, Australia is already my second home. But I mean, you just make me want to come back all the time. Oh my gosh! Also, just while I'm just chatting, sorry, you don't have to play. While I'm chatting, this is the only international show of the whole entire Unapologetically tour. So I just think, like, as absolutely loud and crazy as we can be, we're like setting the tone for tomorrow. I don't know if you've noticed, but we've been playing the record in order of the album. Because I guess I'm just like old school, and I think that that's really how you get to know someone's story, is by listening to the whole album. And so I made this album about my life, the last 3.5-4 years. And you just heard like the angsty breakup mean part of it. And then it goes into just growing up and self-discovery and all of the beauty and the awkwardness that comes with that. And you know, this is one of the last songs that we wrote for the album, and I thought that it was kind of going to be my baby. But I'm realizing that maybe it's just for anyone in the in-between. I thought the cold would last forever. Didn't know that there was something better. So how do I live without you? I want to know. How do I breathe without you?
Thank you.
Concert was simply amazing. Kelsea is such a kind soul. There was this little girl who drew her picture, and she was like, "Oh, come after the concert, I'll get someone to like bring you to backstage, and we can take selfies." So for anyone who aspires to make it in the music industry, she is definitely your role model, not just for country musicians but for everyone. I first started listening to her when I was in high school. She still wasn't that big at the time, and I remember her first album the first time came out. I was like, oh, this girl can sing, she can really sing, she can rock. Anyway, I really enjoyed the concert, and hopefully I'll remember to vlog tomorrow. Yeah, so see you later, bye. Always wanna